Hey everybody, this is Nikki from That Christian Fam, aka The King's Realm, and today we're going to be talking about what's consuming your thoughts, learning how to guard your mind, and realizing the power of positive thinking.
You're watching That Christian Fam.
All right, thank you so much for joining me today on this video. We do hope, before we jump into the meat of the video, that you subscribe to our YouTube channel. We're That Christian Fam. Also, check us out on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. All right, so today we're talking about what's consuming your thoughts, learning how to guard your mind, and realizing the power of positive thinking. Many of us have heard of Joyce Meyer's Battlefield of the Mind, and it's an awesome book that just kind of talks about how the enemy will use your mind as a battlefield to try to get you to believe negative thoughts about yourself, to try to get you to look at situations in a negative light, to cause you to lose focus of the vision, the mission, and the purpose that God has placed you here on this earth for. So if you think about why the mind would be a battlefield, or why the enemy would attack your mind, it makes total sense, because our mind is like our control tower. And if he can get in your mind and get that planted and plant that seed of doubt, of negativity, of distraction, then he can get you to sit on that and then get it to grow and to manifest. And then that will turn into your words that you're professing over your life. That will turn into your actions. And some of us have heard that saying, and I'm actually going to read it. It's a quote that says, "Be careful of your thoughts, for your thoughts become your words. Be careful of your words, for your words become your actions. Be careful of your actions, for your actions become your habits. And be careful of your habits, for your habits become your character." So we have to be very mindful of what we're keeping on our minds. And then if you think about Colossians 3:2, which helps us to keep a focus on what we're thinking about as well, it says, "Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth." There are so many things that can cause distractions, that can cause us to lose sight, that could cause us to believe negative things about ourselves that God did not place within us. So it's very important that we do as Romans 12:2 says, and daily renew our mind, so that we are not conform to the ways of this world, but we're transformed, like it says, by the renewing of our minds on a daily basis. And it is, it's like Joyce Meyer was saying, it's a constant battle. You know, it's never anything that you're just going to totally master, but it's something that you have to be intentional about on a daily basis. So I want to give a shout out to someone who I call Aunt Sherry, and she's was a very important person in my life as I was growing up. And I remember as a teenager, I was discouraged about something. I can't remember exactly what it was, but I remember going over to her house and I was upset. And I remember sitting on her couch and she introduced me to a scripture that is still planted in my heart to this very day. So the scripture that she gave me was Philippians 4:8. And if you bear with me, and I know this is a common scripture that a lot of us probably have heard along the way, but I want to pull it up and I want to actually read through it together. And I want us that to be one of our key focuses for today's video. So Philippians 4:8 says, "Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things." And that leads me to how we can gain confidence and power and, you know, guard our minds, because there's a lot of things that will come against us, and that a lot of negativity that the enemy will try to plant within us, and sometimes even our surroundings, you know, will try to get us to believe certain things about our situation that do not line up with what the Word of God says about it. So we do have to do exactly what Philippians 4:8 says, and think about those positive things. Think about the things that are going right. If the enemy can plant seeds of negativity and doubt in your mind, eventually it will grow and it will become action. So you may be saying, okay, Nikki, what are some practical ways that I can guard my mind? Because we want practical ways too. We always want it to be founded on the Word of God, but what are some things that we can do on the day-to-day basis to guard our minds? So one thing that I can say is to focus on the positive. There are times where we can kind of sink into that downward spiral of focusing on what is not going right. You know, it's easy to see, okay, this needs fixed, or that needs fixed, or this has to get paid, or that has to get paid, or this went wrong, or that. It's easy to look at life in that whole glass half empty light, but it's more challenging to look at it from a positive. But it's rewarding if you start looking at things from the glass half full perspective. Now look at what's going right in your life. Count your blessings. And if you were to write it down on a piece of paper, I can guarantee you that the good will always outweigh the bad, even though it may feel the other way around sometimes. So that's practical way number one, is to focus on the positive. Think of what is going right and count your blessings. Two, we have to be mindful of what we are putting in. We have to be mindful about what we are feeding our bodies. We have to stay full of the Word of God. And try to eliminate junk. We hear a lot about, you know, when people are doing food studies and brain foods and things that'll help to your brain to function and work hard and, you know, be at its best and help your body to work. Well, there's also mind food. You know, we don't want to, just like you don't want to put a lot of junk into your body, and how sugar and things of that nature can slow your mind, your brain down from processing. Well, there are things that we can be mindful to feed our spirit and our mind in order to make sure that we are keeping our minds focused on what it needs to be focused on. So that means we have to be mindful of the TV that we watch. Are we feeding ourselves a lot of junk? A lot of, and I'm not saying all reality shows are bad, but are we looking at some things where it's just constantly full of drama? And then that's what we're seeing, so that to where we get into certain situations to where we're responding the same way that we're seeing on TV. Think about the movies we're watching. You know, what are we really feeding ourselves? Is every other word getting bleeped out, or is it not getting bleeped out? To where if something angers us, that's the first thing that kind of comes up, because that's what we're putting in. Think about the music you're listening to. Have you ever listened to music and it kind of puts you in a certain mood? I've heard a lot of people that have talked about, and just in conversation, to where, oh, well, if I'm mad, I put on this type of music because it kind of gets me in this mode. Or, you know, I was ready. Athletes will put on a certain type of pump it up music because it sets the tone for the way that they're going to act. So we just have to be mindful of what we're feeding ourselves. Also, we have to remember what God has done in order to guard our minds and realize the power of positive thinking. My pastor just this very past weekend said that a lot of times it's not that we need to continuously ask for God to do more and bless us with this and that and the other. Sometimes we simply just need to remember what He has already done. And there is power in that, because when you're feeling defeated, and when you're feeling like, oh, my purpose is over, or when you're feeling like, I don't understand why I'm going through this, or how I'm going to get out of this, you can look back and remember, wow, God did this for me before. Wow, He delivered me before. Wow, He made a way before. And that gives us power in knowing, you know what? I don't have to be defeated. I know I have the victory through Jesus Christ, and He has proven Himself before, so I know that He can do it again. So when you think on positive things, it will guide your actions. Think about if you just sit around and you believe those negative confessions, then you're going to start to act accordingly. So when we think on positive things, it helps to guide our actions, and it also helps us to maintain focus. I know this video hasn't been very long, but I just want to hop on real quick and remind us to consider what's consuming our thoughts. What are we giving time to? And when we're staying focused on those positive things, it helps us to remember that we don't have time for foolishness. That's kind of been one of my new things lately. It's like, I just don't have time. If it's foolishness, I don't have time. I have to dismiss it. Think about what's really consuming your thoughts. What's on your mind? What are you feeding? yourself, and how can we spend more time in the Word of God and with time talking with Daddy so that those things will come up when we need it and keep us focused, because we need it all the time. We need the Word of God all the time. So in those trying times, instead of reverting back to negativity, when we have the Word of God in us, then those scriptures, the Holy Spirit will bring those back to our remembrance, and we're able to quote the Word of God and state the Word of God over our lives, proclaim it over our lives. Remember that there is power in your thoughts, because your thoughts will become your words, and your words will become your way of being and living it out and how you act in your character. So this has been Nikki from That Christian Fam, aka The King's Realm. I hope this has been a blessing to someone. What's on your mind? Philippians 4:8, and what's consuming your thoughts? All right, stay encouraged. Thank you for sticking with me for these minutes, and I will see you the next video.
You didn't look like you did on the gram when I pulled up. No. You didn't look like you did on the gram when I pulled up. No. The flesh is never satisfied. I've tried time and time to gratify. Seems like every time the Pharisee dime can't quite crucify my carnal mind. The lust that drives the man inside seems unchanged, although that El Shaddai died. I can't lie to try to pacify. Run full speed to send to pass the time.